Hello and welcome to the MTG Josh channel. If you haven't been here before, this is the place to go to find all the latest Historic Brawl Commander videos from the latest sets, and a lot of old popular ones have been done as well. So please check out my back catalogue and let's get in today's video. Just what we need, some early one drops. Let's go for the Halfling. Going before green deck is always a delight, gives you a definite edge there. I love how the tapper wanted to use both of our coloured mana rather than use the Delight Halfling. Bit peculiar. Turn two, we have already three creatures out. This is kind of like the dream. What if we did Legion's Landing gives us a creature. Oh my, this is crazy. 2, 3, 4. This is the most aggressive. Oh my goodness, and an Adeline as well. I'm pretty sure I could have maybe done that a bit better. Maybe attacking, flipping this into a land, but I don't know. I feel like we've already kind of... Oh, they are not going to be happy with this Skyclave Apparition. Blimey, that was aggressive. Hi guys, today we're looking at Buxton, Decorated Host. This is an alchemy-only commander, so you cannot find this in paper. And normally these can be quite problematic due to their power level, but I feel like Buxton is just about okay. It feels probably slightly a little bit too strong. Anything that gives you... lets you cast it out for cheaper with Convoke in this case and get you free stuff to the battlefield is kind of dodgy. We're getting into some dodgy territory here, especially whenever you seek something. So let's just read the whole thing. Beginning of your end step, if you control a tapped creature, seek an unland permanent that costs X or less, where X is the number of tapped creatures you control put on the battlefield. That's scary. And your stuff will probably be tapped because it has Convoke, which means you can tap any creatures to pay one for the creature's color cost. Or generic one. So a lot of the deck is going to be lots of stuff to kind of send out chaff and then kind of tap them to cast Buxton. And a lot of the deck is designed to be very aggressive, and most things are cheap and all make lots of freebies as well. And we have so many one mana dorks now, it's really quite silly. Got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 one mana talks a tap for one on turn one, which whenever you see this, if you ever face this, it feels so demoralizing because on turn two they play a three drop and then suddenly you're like, oh snap, I don't really want to be facing this person anymore. And the deck has all your favorite enablers for, you know, pumping the team, flying the white tree, just the best one we really have. We've got King Darien that makes your guys bigger as well. Really powerful. Trostani makes your guys bigger and gives you 2 1/1s. Mirari's Wake does the same. Armingala makes your entire deck, even cards in your deck, +1/+1, which is ridiculous. Begin anew gives your cards perpetually +1/+1 after you've board wiped. The creature cards in your hand. And then we have Aragorn and Arwen. Whenever it comes into attacks, put counters on each creature you control, which is just... this is like make your own Elesh Norn, kind of crazy. I don't have Elesh Norn in the deck because I feel like 7 mana can be a little bit too expensive to get to. We know she's good. It's kind of boring for me because I know that she's just so powerful. I want to use different things, guys. That's the thing about this channel. I don't need to keep using the same cards over and over again. Let's rotate in some new things here. Season of Gathering, this is really cool as well. It lets you destroy all artifacts or enchantments, draw cards, or put counters on creatures. And we've got Elspeth, Sun's Champion, which is newly introduced to Arena. So these are really cool. Some pet cards that I want to try out. Wily Duke is interesting. It's a 3-mana 4-2, which seems decent until you read his ability. Whenever it becomes tapped, you gain a life and draw a card. Now, normally, you won't be able to do that. But if you make a vehicle deck or use him to convoke, you'll be drawing a card, which is really nice. There's other ways too. And Amara wants to be tapped as well. You want to tap her hard. And when you tap her... she makes a 1-1. Man, that's... when you say that out loud, it sounds like the reproductive cycle. But yes, the deck is just designed to make lots of small things and then benefit off them. Welcoming Vampire draws you cards. Tacacious Welcome draws you cards. Guardian Project, and Toski draws you cards involving creatures as well. It's really cool. Also using the brand new Beezer. So yes, this deck is pretty damn strong. It feels kind of unfair. I mean, I will say that the Alchemy team probably needs to get overseen a bit, because all of these latest Alchemy legends feel like the same card in different colors. They all do get a free thing. When they enter, get a free thing. At the end of the turn, get a free thing. And it's just kind of boring. They're just Ruskos in disguise. They're Grenzos in disguise. They're Itali's in disguise. And I'm kind of sick of that. But I will say, this feels a bit different with the Convoke and Tapped. There is a downside to it. And also the artwork is essentially the Hobbit and Hobbiton. And they've replaced the Dwarves and the Hobbits with rabbits. So it's kind of cool. But yeah, I like the name. I like the artwork. I do like the idea of this card. I think it's fine. It's fine. It's very good. But in a way, can make it boring, because I can just look at the card and go, yeah, that's strong. Let's see how it works. It's going to do quite well. And I hope you enjoy. Stick to the end. This is a really solid hand. We can go for a turn to Ajani, as long as the Avacyn's Pilgrim survives. And that's going to be very, very tough for them to deal with, I think. Unless they have... Okay, they got Esper Sentinel. See how this goes down. Or we could use the Fragment Reality on this and then delay it a little bit. Signet. No, I'm just going to go for the Johnny. Because it's freaking crazy, isn't it? A turn two Walker. So yes, they draw a card. I guess it makes up for the fact they lost one.
Join us peacefully. We need
and we get a Trostani. Oh, that's going to be crazy good. So now they have to put some resources into dealing with this. Probably the Sentinel attacking it and any number of other things. I really do want to kill this, obviously. We do have the Fragment Reality, which is going to be good in it if we can get that off. But at the same time, I want to do my own thing as well. We have to apply pressure, apply threats. If we don't do that, we get left behind. And they had basically a lightning bolt for three. So I can't really complain about that. So how much mana do we have total? Four mana. And next turn, they're going to get Pantalaza. Unless we use Fragment Reality on this. But because it's two mana, it will likely give them a mana dork. So, is that... I think we'll just go for Gala Greeters. And get rid of the Sentinel, please. Because that is irritating. We may have even given them a card when we played that Planeswalker. We'll see. So now we have no... we have no... more removal for the Pentalaza, so we're gonna have to get very lucky. The Gala Greeters is pretty crazy with Trostani Discordant, because this makes two token creatures, but Gala Greeters does not discriminate. It just says whenever another creature, doesn't say non-token, so that's pretty cool. In a weird way, Buxton is Pentalaza, because we kind of convoke, not convoke, we discover Seek. Yeah. Finale X equals 2. That's interesting. What? Is that going to be something bad? 2 mana. Fanatic of Vronus. Interesting. So, do we go for just this? What combination of things can we do? If we do this, we'll have one. No, that's not going to be enough. I think we'll go for Legion's Landing first. Because that's one mana and gives us a creature anyway. And it gives us a trigger with the Gala Greeters as well. Tap for Convoke. Tap for Convoke. Convoke. Is that going to resolve? Nice. And we get a bit more synergy with the Gala Greeters. Swords to Plowshares. Okay, well, that's pretty annoying. Yep, they had the answer. It's a shame it wasn't Path to Exile. That would have given us a land. But I don't know. I feel like going for a 2-mana finale, it was getting rid of a wincon there. But oh well. What do they have in their hand that's 5 mana that they desperately want to cast? Ephemerate. So they're going to get to go again, basically. Right, okay. Any dinosaurs in the deck, bro? Sylvan Tutor. Oh, no. Put that card on top. That could be bad. That could be very bad. Ah, oh, it's a bloody Itali, of course. Well. What else can we really do? Oh, well, let's go for Buxton again. Just keep creating mana, I suppose. And what we'll do is we'll respond to the Itali because we can actually... Ooh, that's actually a really good hit. Because we can get the Savelle land on top of the deck and Savelle something bad on top to give them, maybe? We'll have to see. I don't feel very safe against Itali. I mean, no one does. This deck is so goddamn... I've seen it so many times. So old. It's so old! I don't know why people are obsessed with still using this. So many new cards. Right, so let's fetch into Savelle. Lush Portico. That's actually pretty useful. Forest. Well, I guess we'll just leave that on top because even because it's just I don't know. There's no point. It doesn't make a difference. They exile till they hit another land anyway. So, Declaration of Stone, for God's sake. That is so annoying. Man, do you know what? It's not an Itali deck. It's a Pantlaza deck. It's a goddamn Pantlaza deck. Ah, I'll tell you what would have been interesting though. If they had stolen one of our creatures, we could have actually used Trostani to gain control of it again. But alas, we did not get that lucky. That could have worked out for the best. Imara. Now, the only issue is Itali. If they flip this, it's going to be 11-11 Infect. And that is not going to be very pleasant at all. So I think we just go for Trostani Discordant here. Which is going to give our team some oomph. Oh, and we actually get all the triggers for Gala Greeters because Trostani comes in with 3 creatures in total. So that's actually pretty nice. If we do that, we just die, I think. So, yeah, we'll go for the Monastery Mentor here. We need lots of blockers for Itali. So we'll hold off for now. I'm scared. I'm very scared. So worst case scenario is a board wipe that only kills our things. If they have a Star of Extinction or something, or well, that would kill their stuff as well, but Tooth and Nail, seriously? Shame on you. This is such a net deck. Boring, boring, boring. It's going to be Crater Hoof and, I don't know, what a surprise. I'm going to keep this even though we don't have a turn one Alf Drop. Because I just like having access to a bit of Savelle, dual lands, removal, ramp. It's all good stuff. Some people might just want loads and loads of one drops and small creatures. Maybe you build the deck like that, but I think this version of Buxton I have is a lot more broad. Ooh, board wipe. That's actually pretty good. I think because of the existence of this card, we will actually delay playing creatures and kind of just let them do their thing, maybe. Like was when they played Thalia. Then we'll be able to kill her instantly without having to use Get Lost. Maybe we get two hits. Aftermath Analyst. Okay. Milling stuff. Wow, what was that? Flare of Fortitude. Ooh. That's good. Sweet. So we're going to cultivate now. We've got a really great hand, to be honest. And next turn we can ramp even more just to kind of not troll them as such, but lull them into false sense of security. Or maybe they won't fall for it, you know. But I will say this. Buxton without any creatures is not so great, because if you come in without any creatures and nothing's tapped, it doesn't do anything. So, Creature of the Schism. Do we just board wipe now? Or do we just ramp a bit more? So if they hit somebody while you have the most life, they draw. Alright. Yeah. I think we're just going to ramp and be very, very patient. There is no need to deploy any creatures. When you have a board wipe, you have to be patient. I think that's something a lot of players don't really understand. A lot of people contest me for saying, oh, I shouldn't have board wipes in a deck that cares about creatures. But then my counter argument is, you're not always going to be in front. You're going to be behind at least half of the time. Now, they might not play anything into these guys. With these guys, sorry, should I say. There's one land in there, so I doubt they'd pay 4 mana to just do that, would they? I don't know. And here we go, perfect. And you know what? The Flare of Fortitude is in the bin. So we know they do not have a free spell to give the whole team protection. Oh my goodness. This is going to be crazy. Because we have creature cards in your hand. Perpetually get +1/+1. And we have 3 creatures in our hand. Oh, that's so good. And a Wily Duke as well, which has super synergy with Buxton. Let's just draw a card whenever he becomes tapped. I love design like this because it gives you a problem that you have to solve. When a card is just a good card, I don't really have any interest in it or worth for it. It fits in decks, but then it's not interesting. Wily Duke is super interesting because it's basically saying it wants you to make a vehicle deck, a mount deck, or a convoke deck. 3 options. Perennial Behemoth. Play land from your graveyard? Okay. +2/+7. They don't have any other lands in the graveyard. So do I really care? This is a bit mathematical, this deck. Okay. So Offspring is fantastic in the deck, so we do that. We want to Convoke. Wait, would we have... No, it's fine. Yeah, that's fine. Oh my goodness, and we get Adeline as well. Oh boy. It's not looking good for them. Unless they use a board wipe, then it's looking very, very good for them. But then they just played the Perennial Behemoth. So, which actually, upon closer inspection, has tremendous art. I just love the way that looks. It's organic. It looks mechanical. Very, very cool. So the only thing they can really do now to annoy us would be a board wipe, which would essentially probably win them the game. But you know what? We have to do this because we are a go wide deck. They're going to go for Necrobloom. Okay. That's something that... Is that... Oof. This is something we have to deal with, to be honest. Because that is going to make an annoying amount of creatures. Oh no. And then the perennial behemoth as well. Let's do it again. Oh, okay. So now that is a problem. Oh, that's really annoying, actually. But they don't have any colored mana they can use, so. Right. First things first, kill the Necrobloom. Because that is very problematic. 4, 5, 6. Okay, I think we probably just win here. Because we're going to get a stupid amount of triggers. Just look how many triggers we're going to get. Let's just give everything plus one and turn out of turn. That's a lot. These Warren War Leaders are great. The only crime I have with this card, I think, is the artwork of the actual card looks. It's not too good, but the token is so cute. Look how cute it is. It also looks a bit like it's in Harry Potter land. And yeah, we're going to get a good Convoke here as well. I kind of hope we can Convoke into something that isn't a creature, though. Esper Sentinel. Okay. Not so great. Because if they we'd have any mana up either, so it's a real shame that we probably should have actually tapped the Avacyn for mana to go for these Warren War Leaders, and then we would have had a white mana open. A green mana. It's ironic, right? It's a green thing that taps for white, so we couldn't use it for this. We would have had to use keep one of these open. Tiana. They live ever hopeful. So if they mill. The thing is, this says one or more, so if they had like a scape shift, it would only gain 2 life because it says one or more. But I suppose they can fetch a couple times, gain a few, but I fear that if they don't kill the Warren War Leaders. Yeah, that's just death anyway. They probably should have quit before even trying that, but oh, that felt pretty nice. All right, we'll keep this, mainly because we have Shape of Sanctuary, and I think this is going to be good against Rakdos. Okay, that changes the way we do stuff now. So now we're going to go for Sanctuary next turn into the Guide. Ooh, okay. Yeah. So Bloodghast is annoying because it keeps coming back after being sacked. But I feel like we should be pretty... We should do fairly well here. I'm definitely going to save the sword for this guy because they can make him indestructible, which is very annoying. Infamous Cruel Claw. Okay, or maybe we just get rid of that then. That's terrifying, isn't it? Oh, that's mildly terrifying. Let's just go for this instead. Okay, fine. They're going to get one hit with a Cruel Claw. And we have to be... Oh, this is scary. It's scary! If they go into, like... But the deck isn't built around Cruel Claw. So, I don't know. Will they have 10 drops in it? Maybe. We will see. Whenever another creature enters. Wow. Guide of Souls and Monastery Mentor work together really well. Holy crap. Holy crap. Deluge. Oof. Oh, that's a brutal deluge. So much value we lost there. Fine. Jesus. Well, that's really going to set us back because now we don't have any synergy at all with Buxton. So, let's see what they do. How ironic is this that this is their commander, but the Cruel Claw is the thing I'm trying to get rid of here. That's how powerful Cruel Claw is. Honestly, it's just a joke, this card. Yeah, very powerful. Very powerful. Mayhem Devil. So they didn't have the mana for the Rakdos, it seems. So now we're going to have to play Buxton out with no synergy, which is very sad. And also, interestingly, Mayhem Devil now gets a lot worse now that we have Shape of Sanctuary. Huh? Nope, they want the mana. They want their creature to die to get the mana. That ain't happening, bro. Oh, Aragorn and Arwen. Oh, this is not looking good for them. And it's got six toughness. Llanowar Elves, beautiful. Okay. We're looking good now. So they... This is going to be annoying, not going to lie. Like, indestructible 6-5. That is going to be annoying. But we might do okay with the Flowering of the White Tree out. We'll see. So now I feel as though if they do... Okay. Cottontail Caretaker. I still think we just attack with Aragorn and Buxton. They want to ping something now? But it taps it though. And we draw a card. Mate. I don't know about that. Okay. So now they don't get to block. That is so bizarre. Treasure, surge, prevent. Okay, that doesn't affect us. Okay, well, we're just going to just keep making stuff. Oh my goodness, if the target are stuff, they get bigger. We literally have the ultimate anti-Mayhem Devil technology here. So whenever they target our creatures, we put two counters on. They are so freaking screwed. I think they've just realized how screwed they really are. Mayhem Devil, whenever that targets, now we'll put counters on our creatures and we draw a card. Beautiful. Oh boy, this was such a great hit. Let's go. And we gain one life for each creature we control. Holy moly. Now, obviously, if they have another board wipe in their turn, we are in a lot of trouble. So, we're just going to have to hope that they don't have that. Oh, Selfless Savior. Now, that's a great hit as well. What will we protect? We probably protect Aragorn and Arwen because we can just recast Buxton. The rest would be annoying to lose, but... My god, we're so lucky, especially with all this sack stuff going on. And they've got six life. I have no idea why they did this before we attacked. That was such bad time. They're doing it again! Why? Do it during blocks, dude! I can tell 100%. Pretty sure this guy has never played this. It doesn't feel... I don't know, it just feels really weird. They're trying to find answers, but it's now unable to block. That's the whole point, right? Or at least do it during attacks. Oh my goodness. Target a creature. Okay. They're just giving us loads of cards. Of course we're going to draw a card, yes. One damage to that creature. Okay. It has one more toughness, my friend. I think I know what they're trying to do here. They're trying to get us to use... Although this has got ward, though. Every time they target us, two counters on all of our guys. That's crazy. Armingala, get lost. Yeah, I can see they've got the get lost, but what's that going to do? We've got Fateful Absence. Crazy. I'm going to kill this in response, because clearly they're trying to do something weird here with this Pitiless Plunderer. I feel like something weird's going off. They're trying to harvest mana for something. Do they have a board wipe in their hand? They're trying to build up enough mana to do that, maybe? Maybe that's what the plan was. But that's exactly why... Okay, that means... Right. So we'll sack it. We'll give Aragorn and Arwen indestructible, which gives them, ironically, another trigger. I mean, they could use Get Lost, but then that... Yeah, I don't know. Okay, fine, we're going to have to change tack. We're going to put candles on other things then. I've never seen so many triggers in one turn. This is crazy. Draw. Oh, Rite of Harmony, that's good. Okay. We have such a lethal attack force, though. I'm not really sure how they're going to... Bale push. Bloomin' heck. That Mayhem Devil's crazy, honestly. I would like to draw another creature there. That would be nice. How many things did they kill? Wear down. We can destroy two artifacts and enchantments, but that ain't going to happen, is it, sadly? We got maps. I guess we'll use some of these. Oh, another trigger. That Mayhem Devil. Tell me you're safe keeping that in a creature. We just need some creatures, bro. I suppose we'll get these out of the way. Down to 20. Are we going to die? Cathars Crusade. Again, that's not really helpful. Crazy amount of power. They have to block everything now. So... Until your next end step, you may play those cards. Yeah, I guess I see the validity of doing it. I feel like we're actually going to die. Land and that. Okay. But then they do have to still block, though. So... Whenever a creature or enchantment enters, draw a card. I feel like I'm tempted to do this anyway, just in case we get a creature with a Buxton. Oh man, are we going to lose to this Rakdos? Exile 0, okay. They've basically eaten all of our cards, well, sort of. They don't really have much left to do. Treasures. Okay, thank goodness that's dead. We'll go for Rite of Harmony. Because if we get a creature with the Bucks, then we get to draw at least one. And then we'll pass. Creature? Oh, that's pretty good. So we do get to draw one. Nice. Oh, this has been a kind of a very, very technical match. Like, if they stole a board wipe from us with this, that would have been pretty concerning. But now I think, I don't really know. The Bloodghast is annoyingly synergistic with the Rakdos. Let's see what timing they're going to go for. Are they going to do the thing? They're going to attack this time? Wow, they're brave. They don't have the Mayhem Devil anymore, though. Does that mean this is going to be a board wipe, then? They've got so much mana. I just have to pray they do not get anything crazy good from us. Declaration in stone. Choose another creature artifact. When it's put into graveyard this turn, return it to the battlefield. Ah. But if, at least we get to draw a card. So, Blood on the Bloody Snow. When it's put into the graveyard, return that card to the battlefield under its owner's control. Okay, we'll give Aragorn. So when this dies, it comes back. This is instant, so I could have done this in response. What means if I press control here? Do I still have time? Or has it been chosen already? Move your commander to your command zone. Yes. Trigger. Do that in response to draw one card. It's efficient, I suppose. So Aragorn comes back in. They've got the bloody Mayhem Devil back. That's 5 extra damage. Oh, we've got the Elspeth Sun's Champion. But again, they've got another creature. God damn it. They're going to kill us with that bloody Mayhem Devil, aren't they? Oh. This is really bad. Oh. Okay. Well, yeah, that makes sense, yeah. More damage coming in. Goodness me. All of these treasures from that bloody Pitiless Plunderer as well. Lands. We don't need more lands. Really? That is so ridiculous. I'm going to destroy one of these before we go for the Elspeth. So they can't ping her as easily. Oh, I don't like this. So we have to minus to get rid of the Mayhem Devil. But it does mean we lose the Elspeth, sadly. This Mayhem Devil has caused no end of problems. Yep, she dies. I mean, do they want to get rid of it? Lightning Bolt. Down to 7. No way. That is so irritating. They got us with that. Oh, jeez. I actually cannot believe we lost that game. I honestly thought we had that in the bag. Yeah? The lightning bolt did it. Okay. Yeah, I'm a bit salty about that. Jeez. And to think they did some weird stuff early on, but... Yeah, there we go. And this Solemn Mirari's Wake to boot. But you know what? We drew a hell of a lot of lands, don't you think? A lot of lands. Did you know that you can help my channel by watching another one of my videos? Go ahead. You know you want to.